We now move on to look at the swearing-in of commissioners, where at a time when the country is getting polarized by hardened political positions on the referendum proposals by a section of the political divide, new National Cohesion and Integration Commissioners have been sworn in. Now, speaking exclusively to WTV, the Commission's new chairman, Francis Ole Kaparo, emphasized on the need for collaborations and partnerships between his team, government agencies, and the public.
When President Uhuru Kenyatta appointed Francis Ole Kaparo to take over NCSC's chairmanship, questions were raised as to whether the former National Assembly Speaker is equal to the task, but with no doubt his swearing in Monday means that the huge assignment of ensuring Kenyans are living in a cohesive society is entirely under him. Kenyans will now depend on him for solutions to thorny issues that face them. However, Kaparo has emphasized the need for concerted efforts from the public to overcome national division and negative ethnicity.
It is something that all of us must be involved. You too must be involved. I cannot deal with it conclusively alone. This commission can't. It's a national problem. It's a national issue. The people of Kenya must first accept that we have a problem. And if we do have a problem, then we must sort out that problem. How we do that is something that all of us must think together, because nobody has monopoly of knowledge. I do not pretend to have monopoly of knowledge, neither do I pretend to be all-knowing or that I am all-powerful. Only God is. I'm not, and I have never been anywhere near God.
Since his appointment on September 11th, concerns have been raised that his close association with the Jubilee Coalition may compromise his delivery of services, especially if top politicians will engage in hate mongering and related transgressions. Despite this, Kaparo has expressed his optimism to serve Kenyans without allowing external factors to interfere with his work. And although the former commissioners led by Mzalendo Kibunja were accused of failure to execute their role, effectively, they had a good share of the achievements.
They did the best they can under the circumstances. Yeah? Even leading to the last general election. They did a wonderful job to bring down hate speech, to bring down speech actions that could destroy the nation. You know, they did very well under the circumstances.
Importantly, Kaparo has identified the loopholes from the former commissioners and hopes to tackle them.
That we know we don't have enough personnel, that we know, and we'll talk to government again. We don't have enough financial resources, we'll talk to government. We also know that prosecutions have been slow, and when they have been taken to court, a lot of them have not even succeeded. We'll have to deal with that as well. But the most important thing is not to jail people. It's to save them from jail and from death and from other conflict. And that basically is what we intend to do.
Kenya has been without a cohesion commission since the Kibunja team left. Although the new commissioners take over the challenge of creating a new image by eliminating hate speech, strengthening the legal framework and identifying threats to cohesion, which includes bad politics, economic inequality, and unresolved historical injustices, are key steps that the commission could bank on to achieve harmony in the country.